So as you can see, I've already prepped these nails. I've filed the old set off and done the cuticle work, prepped the nails, put primer on, and now I'm just in the process of putting the clear acrylic base down first on every nail. I always do a clear base first, so it's easier to file back down to when my client comes back. Now this is my people on the live feed asking what design we're doing, so my client was showing me the design that she'd picked. Please ignore the blister on my finger. It was from when I burnt myself on my oven. It's not very nice. So now I'm just putting the full colour, like the milky white colour, on the pinky nail. I think we used Blush by CJP, I think that's what it's called. It's like slightly like pinky white, like a milky pinky white. And I think this is where I'm trying to decide, remember which colours go on which nail. How beautiful are my client's nails, by the way? This colour, me and my client ended up mixing it before we started, so God knows what it is. There's a few different colours in there, and you can see I'm having to work with it a bit differently because it's quite marbly. And also the weather were really hot this day, so me trying to do this ombre was an absolute nightmare. I'm clearly not happy with it after the first time, so I'm going in with more white to try and blend it a bit more. I think this is, yeah, the green and white ombre. I think this one was my favourite one. I will tag the lady whose work, who we were inspired by for this set. Her work is absolutely unbelievable. So nice. This one is just a full plain nail, so I'm just building it with my green. A lot of my acrylic colours that I use are all strength powders, so I don't need to cap these ones. I think when I do the pink one, I do it because it's a colour that I've mixed with all different colours, so I think I just capped it just to be safe. Sure I did. And obviously I'm capping my ombres here because I don't want to file into my ombre. Now this is where you'll see how it's a bit marbly, this colour that I've mixed, because it's just a random colour that I've mixed with a few different colours. We're trying to get the exact colour from the photo, which I obviously didn't have. But it turned out perfect. Just a little bit of faffing to get it to go nice. More faffing. Now it's just the same thing on the other hand. By the way, don't come at me for my nails, because I've got one hand on that's from my holiday that's about 3 or 4 weeks old, and then one hand that's about a week old. But that is what you will always see from me. Unless I'm going somewhere, I hardly ever have a fresh, nice set because I'm too busy. How nice that green is, and this white just ombre is so nice and perfect with it. Then you get to the pink one and it's just a whole other story. I'm blaming the heat. You can literally see it setting as I'm putting it on. An ombre is so much easier to do when you're pulling it down rather than up. But still made it look good. Again, we're just gonna cap them all in clear. Well, cap my ombres and then cap my foam if I haven't already. So now I'm just filing them in using my hand file. I only really ever use my electric file if I've done some kind of geometric design or a French, if I've got any bulk that I need to file down first. Sometimes if they're just a little bit bulky or if there's any acrylic underneath or a bit thick on ends, I might whack it out. But for my shape, I usually just use my hand file. I think it was around this point where we realised that we'd used a green that I'd mixed with the glow-in-the-dark pigment, so it's a good job my client Sam likes glow-in-the-dark nails, because that's what she ended up with by accident. Now that the filing's done, I've brushed the dust off and I'm just giving them a quick wipe over with some acetone. I use little paper wax strips and cut them up because they're better than the lint-free wipes that you get. And then on the ones where I'm doing nail art, I'm putting a gel base coat down first. And then once that's cured, I'll wipe the tacky layer off, and it's just a lot easier for you to hand paint onto, just goes on a lot nicer. pull the hands out of the lamp, quickly wipe them over with acetone, and you've just got a perfect base to paint your nail art onto. Quite an easy design, like a zebra-y type, tiger-y type print. I'm using the CJP white gel paint, I think it's called Snowdrop, and the brush that I'm using is called Line It Fine. I do really like my Line It Fine brush. Yeah, and I always use my thumb as a little palette because it's just easier. Onto the other side. I think we decided not to put top coat over these either because it looked really nice, like kind of textured on top of the base coat, I think. Because these white gel paints, oh, not just the white ones, but these gel paints, they don't have a tacky layer that needs wiping afterwards, so it looked quite nice, so I think we left it like that. This is when we were discussing whether to put top coat on them or not. And we were like, you know what, they look nice like that. So we just went with cuticle oil, I think. Yeah. I don't think they look finished until you put cuticle oil on. How nice. Probably somebody asking me about my grown out nails there. And there we have it. All done. Thanks for watching, guys. Peace out.